Example 3. The question is, find the HCF of 96 and 404 by the prime factorization method. Hence, find their LCM. Okay. So, first they are given you two numbers. By giving the two numbers, they are asking us to find the HCF first. Okay. Then, they are asking us to find HCF using prime factorization method. And then, we are going to find LCM, but LCM is not by prime factorization method. Okay. The question they are saying us to find HCF only by prime factorization method. We will find the LCM using this result. Okay. Are you all ready? Okay. See the solution. The prime factorization of 96 and 404 gives 96 equal to, you prime factorize 96, you will get this, right? 404 is, you will prime factorize like this, and you will get like this. Okay. Now from this, you are writing the HCF of these two numbers. That is, you see what number is common in two of the given numbers. So here see, this factor 2 is common in both 96 and 404. So from this 2, you write 1, 2. I wrote it. Then see, is there is any number that is common in both. So here see another one, 2 you are having, that is common in both, right? So from this 2 you write 1, 2. So you got 2 into 2, you are getting 4 is the HCF. Now what you are doing is, you are finding LCM. You are finding LCM not by prime factorization method, you are finding LCM using this result. Already we learned it, no? Using this result, you are going to find LCM. So here look at this. We are having a result HCF of A comma B into LCM of A comma B is equal to A into B. Am I correct? So here A and B are the two numbers, right? So here in this problem, we are having A equal to 96. We are taking this value, A is equal to 96, B is equal to 404. That's what you are writing. A is equal to 96, B is equal to 404. Now applying A and B values. Okay. So in this formula, in this equation, you can say you are applying, in the place of A you are putting 96, in the place of B you are putting 404. So you will get this value. So from this you are finding LCM. We have to find LCM. No. So already you know the value of HCF and this value also. That's very easy. So you are going to find this LCM. So keep this LCM as it is. Okay. Where it is, you keep it. Don't move it. Keep it. Is equal to, write the value that you are having in the right of this equal to. First you write this value, 96 into 404. Now bring this value to the right hand side. Left hand side is present here. You are bringing HCF to right hand side. When it comes to right hand side, multiplication value will come as div. Okay. It comes in reciprocal. So HCF of 96 by 404 into, in multiplication is having, no, divided by 1. It comes here in reciprocal, so that it will come in the denominator. HCF of 96 comma 404 by 1 come here in reciprocal, so that you get this value divided by this value. Okay. Now what you are doing is, you know, already know the value of HCF of 96 comma 404. So apply that value and cut it, so that you will get 24 into 404, which is equal to, when you multiply this two, you will get this value. So this is LCM of given numbers. So similarly, if any other numbers, they are any two numbers, if they give, you can find the HCF and LCM using this formula. It's very, very easy. Okay. So example 4, you look. Example 4 is also very, very easy. Here they are given you three numbers. Find the HCF and LCM of these three numbers. 6, 72 and 120 using prime factorization. Three numbers they are giving. They are asking us to find LCM and HCF, both of them in prime factorization method, because if three numbers are given means the HCF of these three numbers into LCM of LCM of three numbers will not be equal to A into B into C. Okay. If two numbers are given, HCF of two numbers into LCM of two numbers will be equal to that two number, product of that two numbers. That this this condition will be satisfied only for two numbers. HCF and LCM of two numbers. If three numbers are given, this condition will not satisfy. So you have to go for prime factorization method. Okay, that's why here they are doing prime factorization method. The prime factorization method of 6, 72 and 120 gives 6 equal to, when you prime factorize 6, you will get this. When you prime factorize 72, you will get this. When you prime factorize 120, you will get this. From this, you write like this. And look at this, when you find HCF, you have to identify the factor that you have in all the three numbers. So here you look at this, we are having a 2. The 2 is present in all the three numbers. No? So from this set, you take 1, 2. Got 2. Now look at, is there is any other number that's common in all the three of these? Yes, we are having 3 is common in all the three. So you are from this set, you are taking 1, 3. That is, you are writing 3, 1, 3. So multiply this 2, you are getting 6. So this is the HCF of 3 numbers. Like that, find the LCM of that 3 numbers. That is also very easy. First, you have to write the number that is common in all the three given numbers. So first, among these three, you write 1. Number, that's 2. Among this 3, you get, write 1, 3. Okay, now write the number, first you look at the number that's common in all the 3 given numbers, then you look at the number that is common in at least 2. So here look at this, you're having this 2 that is common in this 2 numbers. No, so from this 2 numbers, you take 1, 2. I wrote it like that. You look at this 2 that is common in this 2. So, you take 1, 2 and write here. Now, look at this. Is there is any number that is common in at least 2? No. So, write the remaining numbers. 3 into 5. Multiply all those. You will get 360. So, this is the LCM of given 3 numbers. Okay. As I told you earlier, HCF of 3 numbers into LCM of 3 numbers will not be equal to the product of 3 numbers. Okay. If 3 numbers are given, this condition is not going to satisfy. But if 2 numbers are given, this condition you can apply to find the LCM or HCF. First, any one of the value HCF you find using prime factorization and using the condition you have learned here. Using this condition, you find LCM. Any one of the value, or you can find LCM using prime factorization method. And then HCF using this condition. That's your wish. Okay. So it's better to find HCF using prime factorization and then LCM using this remark, or you can say this result. Okay. Use this result to find LCM. If HCF is known, you can use this result to find LCM. Okay. In simple way, I can say it like this.